Make and test conjectures. Well, what is a conjecture? It is a generalization that you think is true, such as you would have learned in science, a theory, okay, or a hypothesis. It's something which you can predict or what you guess. It's a question, okay? So any question you ask can always be answered with a yes or a no, or with testing. You can always test every question you have, and you will find every science experiment will do this, okay? You will test lots and lots of times. And we are also going to do the same in math, okay? So we have a number of statements, and we are going to test them to see if it's true or it makes sense. Such as number one, if a number is divisible by 8, it is also divisible by 2 and 4. So this statement is a generalization, okay? So now we need to test it to see if it's true or false. Now, we should always test something as a minimum 3 times, okay? One test is never enough. You have to do it multiple times, okay? Let's take the 8 times table, because our generalization is saying if a number is divisible by 8, divisible in the sense that the answer, the quotient, is a whole number, then it is also divisible by 2 and 4. Now then, if a number is divisible by 8, then it must be in the 8 times table. So right now, we're thinking of multiples of 8. 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, and so on. Now then, are these numbers that I just mentioned, are they also divisible by 2 and 4? Let's test it, okay? First of all, we know that not only is 2 times 4 8, but you cannot make 8 without the 2 and the 4. They are both factors of 8. If these numbers are factors of 8, that means they must also be factors of the multiples of 8, okay? So let's write down some examples, because you always have to test it. Let's take 16. Is it divisible by 2? Yes. Is it divisible by 4? Yes. We get 8 and we get 4. Okay? Let's take 32. Is it divisible by 2? Yes. Every single even number can be divided by 2. And every number in the 8 times table, all the factors of 8 and multiples are even numbers. Okay, so it will always be divisible by 2. But really now what we're looking out for is the 4, the number 4. And is it divisible by 4? Yes. Now then, we have to do one more example, because you should always show 3 different examples that you do. Because you have to make sure. You might think of something that you didn't think of before. Okay, let's go for a bigger number, such as 88. Is it divisible by 2? Yes, 44. Is it divisible by 4? Yes, it's 22. So we have done 3 examples that have proven our statement, our conjecture, correct. And also when you think about it more and more, if you need 8 to make the multiples of 8, then you also need 2 and 4. And if you look in your times tables columns, you'll also see this. Now then, our second statement, the difference of 2 odd numbers is always odd. Difference means to subtract. So let's test the theory, okay? Let's take any 2 random odd numbers. Let's take, and we're doing subtraction, I'll start with a bigger number first. Let's take 9 minus 7. It gives us 2. Now then, this has proven my conjecture to be incorrect, but I need to do more examples just to make sure, just to be safe. Let's do number 1, 11 minus 3, and that gives us 8. Now this has only backed up the first example. Now let's do one more. Let's do 21 minus 7, 14. So now I can say I've done enough examples to show that this conjecture is not correct. And we can also change this one to say the difference of two odd numbers is always even. And we've proven that to be correct.